everybody. Welcome to my very first cooking stream. Hopefully you can hear me okay. The mic's a little further away from me than usual. Tonight I'm going to be making maple curry chicken, which is a recipe I've made quite a few times before, just not live with the cameras and everything. So we'll see how this goes. Hopefully it'll go well. Gotta admit, I'm a little nervous. But without any further ado, let me go ahead and start. So, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start the rice. So I'm going to get some water here. I got to get one and a half cups. I'm going to go for like 3 cups of rice total. So I want to do 1.5 cups of water. Put that up to the mark. And here we go. Maybe you can't, I don't know if you can see it, but it's 1.5. John Kulis, welcome. It may be something I do. Not sure yet. We'll see how tonight goes. Alright, so I'm gonna pour this into the pot. There we go. Planetary, welcome. Not the most flexible, unfortunately, but this is just kind of a test run to see if this is something that I can do. But yeah, okay, so got that. I'll turn on the burner. Got it on like low medium heat. So wait for that to start boiling. Then I got the rice up here in the cupboard. There we go, instant rice. Oh. Okay, hopefully that is that better, HR Johnson? Can you hear me? And Mr. Plow,
that chair kind of
broke. it didn't quite hold up. I tried sitting on it and it broke under my weight. I think there was just something that wasn't tightened enough there. I don't know, it was a little weird.
But yeah,
something I'd completely forgotten. I just blended into the background, so it's funny that you noticed it. Alright, so, I guess it's gonna be a minute before I have to pour the rice in. Although I will get ready first. Like, 1 cup measure out. This up all the way to the top. That's pretty. Yeah, that's about right. Yeah, just to make it easier on myself, I'll also fill up this half cup just so I can pour them both in at the same time. Once the water is boiling. Alright, there we go. Alright, so now that I got those poured, I'll go ahead and put the rice back in the cupboard. Come to think of it, if I do this more in the future, I may need to get more cameras. I just have this one and the one that's here on my computer, and it's not quite enough to get the whole picture. But like I said, this is just kind of a test run to see how it works for me to do this. I guess without any further ado, let me go ahead and shift the camera over once again to the cutting board, where I'm going to go ahead and start cutting the chicken up. Down here.
Stuffing is being a little difficult.
Oh my gosh. Okay, I think I got it.
There we go. Chicken, 6 pieces of chicken, and 7 pieces of chicken.
John Kulis, that's cool. Good to hear. Yeah, my day wasn't quite as exciting. I've pretty much been at home all day. Just working on coloring and drawing stuff.
Chicken cutting started. Ooh, this one's got a bit of a... Oh yeah, there's like this little bit of tissue here that's connecting the two chunks. Gotta really cut to get through it. Okay, there we go. Kind of looking back and forth between the my computer screen and the chicken, so hopefully this is all staying relatively on camera and it's not getting out of the camera's range. Looks like the water's starting to get close to boiling, so the rice will be ready to cook soon. Tenderloins left to cut. Looks like the water is just about... Yeah, it looks like it's boiling now, so I'll just finish cutting this up, and then I'll go ahead and add the rice to the water and stir it in. But I'm gonna wash my hands first, because, you know, raw chicken and all. Mr. Plow, like, probably a little over an hour, maybe. The recipe as written on all recipes says, I think, like 55 minutes, which is just kind of a rough estimate. It usually takes me a little longer than it says the recipe should. Maybe it's because I'm overly cautious, or maybe because I'm just slow, but it does usually take me a little more time than what the recipe says. Let me go ahead and wash my hands here so I'm not, touching the rice cups with germy hands.
appetizer, it does feel like chicken tonight. It's definitely a chicken kind of evening. Alright. There we go.
Hands are washed. You go ahead and shift the camera back over again. This is one thing I'm probably going to have to improve on in the future. But yeah, here we go. It's right here. Alright. Turn off the heat, put this lid on, put it off to the side, and it'll just cook on its own. It's pretty handy. Alright, so let me see what I got next here. I guess now I start cooking the chicken. Push the chicken into the pan. Slimy. All right, now we're getting started. Some of the pucks on sides. Awesome, got a long ways to go. So, not much really going to happen for the next couple minutes, just gonna, you know, keep stirring the chicken around until it cooks. Sorry, I mean, I'm open to chat if anyone wants to make any conversation with me. Whatever you feel like just watching, that's cool too. HR, cool. I just realized, I never put the chat on screen. That's gonna make it kind of awkward watching the replay and hearing me respond to, you know, comments that weren't shown on screen. Well, I know that for next time then. And Mr. Plow, I have made this quite a few times. I figured it'd be best to, you know, do a recipe I was already familiar with rather than try making something I never made before. I mean, I have kind of discovered that, you know, a lot of recipes do kind of, you know, the processes are kind of similar from one to the other.
So making a new recipe that isn't the same as what it could be similar to one I've already made, so it wouldn't be that much of a shift, but I figured I would just play it safe. Chicken's looking pretty good. Still got quite a bit of pink though, so not ready to add other ingredients yet. I think I might have actually wanted to put olive oil in here first, just to for cooking the chicken, because I can see a little bit of it sticking to the bottom of the pan. Nothing major, but makes me a little nervous. Mr. Plow, it does come from maple syrup. I actually have it sitting on the counter. Let me go ahead and grab it really quick. There we go. Pure maple syrup. This is what I'm going to be using. And I'll be totally honest, I don't really taste it that much in the actual final product. It mainly just tastes like curry because the curry flavor is really, really strong. And I actually only use half the curry that's suggested in the recipe. Like, the recipe calls for 2 tablespoons. I do 1 tablespoon because I don't want that much curry flavor. Stuff is spicy. And really, just 1 tablespoon of curry is plenty. Like, I still get a full-on curry flavor. But it's not too hot, it's just spicy enough, and I dig it. I wonder if I can turn the light on here, that might make things a little better. Should have thought to do that earlier. First time, doing it live. So maybe just start breaking up pieces of chicken here so I can make sure they're getting cooked all the way through. It looks like we're just about done here with the cooking chicken part. I still see some pink in that one. So I apologize if the view of the skillet here isn't the best. I would preferably have the camera pointed right over the skillet, but with all the steam coming off of it, I figured that might not be a good idea. So I'll just kind of have it off to the side like this. Calling it good on the chicken. So I'm gonna go ahead and set this aside for just a second. Yeah, what's the next step here? Alright. So I got some sugar here. Need to sprinkle 1 teaspoon. Oh, wait, no. I actually missed a couple steps there. First, I'm gonna use onion powder. The recipe calls for onion, but because I'm lazy, I'm just using onion powder. There we go. Onion powder. Garlic. Got the garlic right here. Garlic and onion powder. That's funny, Mike Grady. Great to see you here.
Yeah, we go ahead and add the garlic. I forgot to do that earlier.
Alright, so 3 cloves of garlic minced. I believe 1 clove of garlic is roughly a teaspoon, so I'll be adding 3 teaspoons of garlic to the chicken. Do that here. One, 2, and 3 is a magic number. Okay. Oh my gosh, hold on a second. Okay, I think we're back. Wow. Yeah, my laptop battery died, and that just kind of messed everything up. Alright, so okay, I guess I'll try to get back on my feet here. Alright, so I got the garlic added to the chicken. I'm gonna go ahead and add the onion powder. I've not opened yet. I gotta open this one. So I was planning on uploading this whole stream to YouTube, but because of OBS crashing, yeah, it's not gonna happen. But I am streaming to Facebook, so it should stay there. At least. Sorry I'm rambling. Just kind of frazzled. Alright, there we go. Add the onion powder and stir it in. Next up, I gotta add the sugar. So, 1 teaspoon, since I already used the teaspoon measure for the garlic, I'm gonna go ahead and use the 1/2 teaspoon measure for the sugar. Sprinkle out. Mr. Plow, I have not. If I'm feeling ambitious, I might try that sometime. There we go, sugar is added and stirred in. Go ahead and look at the next step here. Alright, so next I'm going to add the maple syrup. Calls for 1/4 cup. Alright, so here we go. Open this baby up. Mike Brady, no, do not add syrup to your tacos. Oh, Irene Pena, did you just get here? Because if you were here a couple minutes ago, no, this is definitely not the opposite of a fail stream. I just had my laptop battery die on me, so I ended up having to restart the stream after a few minutes of nothing. That sucked. But I'm back, hopefully for good this time. Alright, so adding 1/4 cup of syrup to the measuring cup here. Go ahead and add it into the pan with the chicken. Mm. Irene Pena Music's husband, Great Hippo Gaming, was just doing a video game fail stream a little while ago. He might have just finished, actually. He was playing the likes of the NES classics, Back to the Future, Ghosts and Goblins, and the original Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles game. All of which are notoriously difficult. Next up, we got a curry paste. Easily the strongest ingredient in this entire recipe. And like I said earlier, it calls for 2 tablespoons. I'm gonna just do 1 tablespoon because that's more than enough, honestly. Also need to rinse off this teaspoon here because I still have garlic on it. Ah yes, there are a few food items Mike Brady likes less than cilantro. In fact, that might be, actually there might not be anything he enjoys less than cilantro. I actually even made a joke about that in a comic I made featuring Mike Brady, for his character called Wonder Dad, and his main weakness, basically his equivalent to kryptonite, is cilantro. So he loses his powers when he comes in contact with cilantro. Oh yeah, dill. I'm not a big fan of dill either. Alright, Irene, no problem. Thanks so much for stopping by. I think I got this all cleaned up now. So, let me go ahead and start scooping some curry into the chicken. Alright, so 3 of these, this is 1 teaspoon, so 3 of these will make a tablespoon. Basic kitchen math. There we go. Nice big glob of red. So I'm going to stir that in. There's a lot of just adding ingredients, stir. That's a lot of the recipe. In fact, it's probably most recipes, if I'm being honest. Alright, so stirring the curry paste in. Next up, I got the chicken broth. Got a can right here. I gotta use my snazzy electric can opener for this one. Let me just turn the attention over here. And, oops. Hey look, a DJ Mike Brady water bottle. Alright, we go ahead and here. Alright. Okay. Yeah, Mike Brady, it's been pretty good to have. Though, there are times where it the pointy thing just doesn't sink into the lid, but this gear will still move, so it will start ripping the labeling, but the actual can won't open, so that's kind of annoying. But in general, yeah, it's been good to have. Alright, rinsing out the cup so I can pour a cup and a half, a cup and a quarter, I should say, in here. There we go. Alright, now I'm gonna awkwardly adjust the camera back over to the skillet view. The snow view. Okay. That should do it. Pour over the chicken. Rinse this off again because next up we got the heavy cream. And I love me some heavy cream in my food. Like half the recipes I make probably have heavy cream in them. Right. Heavy whipping cream. Which I need a half cup of for this recipe. Yeah, that's a half cup. Alright, Planetary. Laundry's important. Thanks so much for the lurk. Alright. Go ahead and pour the cream in, and of course, it'll change the color quite a bit. It'll suddenly get much lighter and creamier. Cup out of the view. Alright. I think at this point it's just a matter of just kind of stirring and letting it thicken a bit. Recipe on my phone. Yeah, now this is just the part where I just let it simmer. Wow, 40 years, that's really impressive, Mike Brady. Mr. Plow, I might have to try that sometime. You know, I do actually have some French toast in the fridge. Would that work? I can have this over French toast. Might be a little weird, but I could do it. I mean, I had a scrambled egg sandwich with, it was an egg salad sandwich with the waffles in place of bread, so that was interesting. I've never actually had chicken and waffles. I keep seeing it on the menu at a lot of restaurants I've gone to, but I've never actually ordered it. Sometime I'm gonna have to probably finally try it. It just seem like kind of a weird combination. Like, I don't know if those would really go together, or if it would just be tasting chicken and also waffles. Like, I don't know if they'd really blend. It would just be these two completely random things just there on the same plate. Mr. Plow, I assume you've had chicken and waffles once? Or have you? If anyone in the chat's had chicken and waffles before, let me know what you thought of it. Did they really go well together, or is it just kind of like, oh, it's just two random items on a plate at the same time? Because it can, combinations can be like that. Like, sometimes two ingredients will go unexpectedly well together, and then other times it's like, no. Mike Brady, I guess we're on the same page. There's just one more step after I let this simmer for a little bit longer. I can add some cream cheese in to finish it off. Cream cheese is another ingredient I have a fondness for. Not so much when I was a kid, but nowadays I really like cream cheese. I think it's the right term, the heat. And now I got some cream cheese some green cheese I'm gonna add in. Well, softened cream cheese, unfortunately, but I'll take my part. Probably should have taken it out of the fridge earlier. All right,
Boy, that'd be something, Mr. Boyle. You know, there was one recipe I did where it did actually call for an entire brick of cream cheese. I think it was these, cream cheese squares, kind of like these cinnamon rolls, but as bars. They were bar-shaped cinnamon rolls. And I think that recipe for the frosting, it called for an entire brick of cream cheese. So, yeah, it was literally like I just kind of just opened it and then plopped it right in. Throw this in gradually. Still pretty chunky in here. Chicken curry cheesecake. I mean, it might taste fine. Maybe. I mean, I like curry. I like cheesecake, but. Together? The home stretch here. Just gotta let the cream cheese dissolve in there a little more and I'll be done. I mean, if they did put that out as a blizzard, I might just get a mini just out of sheer curiosity. And then maybe only take like one bite of it. And then maybe take one more just to fully process that this is a real thing that exists. I mean, there's probably been weirder ice cream flavors out there. Pretty well dissolved in there. You just see a few little tiny specks, but that's about it. So, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and turn off the heat. Get myself a plate. Here. Let me also clean up my station here. I've got a lot of ingredients still out that don't need to be out anymore. Off the rice. Put some rice on a plate. And then add the curry chicken. You can see it okay. Alright, and I just realized I still have my Invisalign aligners in, so I gotta go take those out really quick so I can give this a taste. Be right back. pork. See how this turned out. Ooh. It's a little hot. I'm gonna have to wait a minute. But yeah, here's the here's how it turned out. Maybe hopefully you can see it good. But yeah, I guess that's about it. So I think aside from the crash there in the middle, this was a pretty good first attempt at a cooking stream. Did you all think so, or do you think maybe I probably still have a long ways to go? You can be honest. I mean, I know this was I kind of just rush into this a bit. Probably could have done a little more planning beforehand. Tuning in and watching me make dinner. I guess I'll just go ahead and find a raid target. Let me see. Looks like Sandman, one of my friends on Twitch, Sandman, is live. He's doing a music set. I'll go ahead and give him a raid. Definitely go give him a follow if you haven't already. He is a great music streamer here on Twitch. And I'll see you all on Wednesday for Draw Something. Thank you, Mike Brady and Mr. Plow. Oh, Mike Brady, good to hear. I'm glad your tacos are delicious. All right, see you guys.